council's point. One of our most talked about right now project is the environmental and the work environment study performed by, part of it is performed by one of his PhD students here and also a former engineer. A lot of the work is also done in cooperation with others such as SPA and Andreas Warner, also an urbanist. It's a very large study, look at work environment, health and safety issues, design and layout, by field studies, mainly field studies, going out to the workplace, charting what's going on, talking to people, taking pictures, you know, we always love to find these, and I guess you can see what's wrong with these. You've got the rain stop and the red star, this is a Danish, old Danish military ship. So, maybe, and it was built in Norway. it's not being used anymore. So. We also have a large project, PhD project, has never been Swedish Maritime Administration. It's looking at the interaction between technical systems, work organization, and decision making on the ship's break to complement the engine studies. There's been a lot of field studies again. That's what we like to do, to get to look at the job as it's being performed in real time by the people. We also perform simulated studies, which is, the analysis is ongoing about this. This is the one small result from this study, is the fairway to noise setting. We asked 56 pilots to rate on a range between a green state, which parts of the fairway are more work intensive or difficult to navigate, and then the follow-up question would be why. It's a very simple method, but then we can focus on some areas and say, well, this is red, why is it red? What makes it red? What could make it yellow? Just to get people to start talking, because you may know, you cannot ask a mariner or seafarers what's difficult about your job, because they would say nothing. Of course, it's part of the image of being a seafarer is nothing difficult, we can solve anything. We have to make little tricks to get them to talk about how we can enter the industry. We have another large project going on in the society. This previous project is by Robert Nielsen. This sensitive piece of Thursday, 1st of November. The information project is, it sounds very wide, and we use the very wide headline for the project to be able to put in things that will turn up later, because this is an area where things happen very quickly. So we have a very wide heading, and basically it's about what the seafarers need to know. When do they need to know this? They don't need to know everything all the time. How should it be presented, and what kind of benefits and drawbacks do you see in various presentations? And this is not just visual presentations, we can talk about three-dimensional sounds, 3D charts, using the senses of feel, which are very underused now. It's a possibility for the future. We're not there yet, but it's close to anything. The first application is looking at three-dimensional charts. There has been an experiment performed comparing three-dimensional charts to normal paper charts and also sort of electronic charts, just the way they look today. The experiment shows that the 3D chart is easier to use and also leads to less roundings. This was just an experiment performed in a room in a laboratory. This was the first one was performed by Thomas Perot at Mellon Research. We thought, you know, he didn't use any seafarers in those times. So again, the seafarers is not able. So Johannes Pearson is a PhD student. Us, and he did it with various groups of seafaring professionals, and they did much better. They were quicker and they were less grounded, but the trend was the same. 3D charts were easier to use, and they had less grounding. And these are available results in a small publication. And we'll keep looking. The next thing will be to see when and where could a 3D chart be used. We're trying to do it human-centered. We're not saying we've got this cool thing, can you use it, please? high speeds, unknown quarters. Like, for instance, various rescue services may have to go places where they haven't had time to plan. Also, perhaps burning could be helpful, but obviously it's not very helpful in the local. So this is an ongoing project. And maybe a field test. We'll have to think about that, because testing equipment in the field or on ships that are already produced. So today, why are you here? So here we just spent on purpose to arrange this breakfast seminar, and we have invited two illustrious speakers. We've got David Carr from BAE Systems. He's got the instruction about you. And he's going to tell us how to develop an integrated human component into large complex picture sites, followed by then he'll tell us about eye tracking and for the three knots. And then he'll tell us about night sensing. David Carr is a professional ergonomist, educated at Gothenburg University of Technology. He has over 20 years' experience in ergonomics and human factors. Not just in relation to ships, but also defense related work and industrial applications. His expertise includes both the physical equipment and workspaces as well as software user applications. He is especially concerned to work dramatically with other technical specialists and deliver practical solutions to human needs. Thank you very much. He works as a human factors consultant for BAE Systems Advanced Technology Centre, which is in Glasgow, Scotland, not in the United States.
So I'm going to be talking about how to use an eloquence, and this will become clear, I hope, in the course of my talk. I'm concerned with the problem of how you integrate the human components into large complex ship designs. The problems we have with working with a very complex product made out of many, many interacting systems designed by large projects. This is where I work. Part of the Advanced Technology Centre, my department is a research and development department mainly, and that's based down in Filton, near Bristol. And that is involved mainly in defence applications and mainly supporting air applications, the air domain. Areas of defense and also in commercial and industrial projects. Although that's a research and development organization, just over a year ago, they brought in another department, my department, which is scattered between Glasgow, Fondra, and Portsmouth. And we are all consultants who are working in real life and design projects. And the idea was to get a synergy with the research and development organization so that we can help find applications for that work and also to tell them about what the needs are in the real world. Where I actually work physically, this is the BAE Systems Scotland Shipyard, formerly known as Gary Shipbuilders.